So Meta released Llama 3.1, and the whole internet is like, wow, what a great model. How come this great model is open source? But the truth is, only few people have actually tested this model. That's why in this tutorial, I'm going to take you through how to use this model yourself very easily. And the fun part of this all is that everything is going to be free because it's a free model. And also, we are going to use it in a way that it will be faster than all the GPT models. Guess what? That's the truth. So if you are ready to experience this with me, let's get right into it and experience this together. Ready to do it? Let's get right into it. Alrighty, so in order to use this model for free, we are going to be using this model via a platform called Grok AI. So Grok AI allows you to use most models, most open source models for free. They provide you with an API, and one thing is that their inference speed is greater or higher than any of the GPT models or any of the models you will use elsewhere. So we are going to be leveraging this, and I'll teach you how to set this all up just in some few minutes. So let's get into that. First of all, I'll close this and I'll open up my Chrome. And what I'll type here is that I'll just type Grok AI or grok.com. I think this should be grok.com. And this will open up the platform for me. So when you open it up here, you can sign up and log in because I have already logged in. So you can see my name right here where I can even log out. So once you have signed in, what you do is that you can even test the model right here. So let's say, for instance, I just want to do something. I can ask, what is a bot? And you guys just look at the speed. Just now, I've gotten the answer to what I've just said. So this is how powerful Grok AI is, okay? They are able to let these models perform very fast, give you a whole lot of responses in very quick manner of time. So you can see I just search what is a bot, and within a sec I've gotten the answer. I can also search something else. Let's say I just say hello, and let's see. So hello, hi, nice to meet you. There is So you can see how fast it is. The response time or the inference time is just fast. It's just crazy. And this is what I love about Grok AI. But this is not why we are here today. Okay, we want to use this in code because we are what? Developers. So as developers, we always want to use APIs and use them in code. We don't want to just enter things in a web browser. So for that, you can just click on start building, and this will take you to the playground. But before we even go there, you can also change different models here. So over here, you can see they have different models. Okay, they have Mistral, they have Llama 3, Llama 3 70 billion parameters, and also we have the one we'll be using today, Llama 3.1 70 billion parameters. And they have even a Google model. So all the open source models are here, and you can use it for free. So let's click on start building. And this should what take us to the playground where we can sign up for API and use it. Okay, so over here you can go to what API keys, and over here in API keys you can see I've already created some API keys. I'm going to revoke this first one and I'll recreate it again. So we have to give this API key a name. And guys, since it's a free API key, I don't expect you guys to use mine because after this tutorial I'm going to revoke this API and you can't get access to it. So I'll call this API key subscribe. So I'll call it subscribe. And for now, if you are watching this tutorial and you have not subscribed yet, why not? Just hit the subscribe button and enjoy. So just hit the subscribe button, please. So we name it subscribe and we'll submit. So once we submit, we can now copy the API key from here and we'll click done. Or okay. So let's go back to our Visual Studio Code, and over here we'll create a new file and we'll call this file .env, okay, .env, and we'll just write API key to API underscore key, and this will be equal to, and then we'll paste the key we've just created. So you save this and you can click this. So let's go back to the platform. We have a lot to do there. All right, so now since we have created the API key, we can go to the playground, okay? And over here in the playground, there are some couple of things you can do. Okay, so you can view code, you can toggle between different models. So we want to use Llama 3.1. So when we click here, you can see these are all the models these people have hosted and you can use for free. I love the fact that it's for free, and as always, open source wins, okay? So I can scroll between these models and I'll choose any of these models I want. But since we are doing it for Llama 3.1, I'll choose Llama 3.1 70 billion parameters. You can test with the 8 billion parameters as well, and you can use any model here you want, okay? But I'll be choosing 3.1 70 billion parameters, and after choosing this, I'll click on view code. All right. So when you open the view code, you can see the code, bare minimum code you need to use this model as a developer. So for that, I can copy this. And if you are not using Python, you can click here, switch to JavaScript and so on. But I'm using Python. I love Python. So I'll copy this code, close this right here, and go back to my code. And over here, I'm going to create a new file, and I'll call this file setup underscore llama.py. So setup llama 3.1.py. And then I will just paste this code in. But in order to use this code, we have to go ahead and install grok. Okay, so it's very simple. We have to what? Install grok. So for that, I'll pull up my terminal. If you are using Windows, just press or Control plus what? Backtick. And this is going to pull up your terminal for you. If you are not using Windows, you can just go to these three dots and then click on terminal. And this is going to what? Open the terminal. So any way you want to open it, you can open it. And from there, what you have to do is to what? Install grok. So I've already installed this, but I'll just show you how to install this. I'll just type pip install grok. Just like this, and I'll hit enter. And it should tell me my requirements are already satisfied because I've installed it. But for you, it's going to install grok for you, okay? All right, so it has installed successfully. We have also some message telling us we should upgrade pip, but that's not our concern now. So for now, I can go ahead and clear this terminal and we can test this right here. All right, so first of all, you can see they are what importing grok. And then over here, we have a boilerplate code where you can use to test this model. But before we can test this model here in Visual Studio Code, we have to bring in the API. So we have to also install one other Python library you will be using. So it's called Python ENV. So we can do pip install Python hyphen dot env, okay, dot env, and this should be installed for us. I've already installed this as well. So for you, or in your case, it's going to install it. So after installing it, we can import it. So we can do from dot env. We are going to import load.env or load.env. And over here, we can just say load.env, and then we bring the parentheses. And this will load up all our environment keys for us. So it will automatically load up this API key we have right. So after loading this, we can now go ahead and read this API key. And to do that, we need to import OS. So I'll just do import OS. And we'll use OS to load in this API key. So for that, we'll do what? We'll write key is equal to os dot get env, and in here you can type in the name you've given to your API key. So we have given it API key, so you have to just type the exact name right here in this parenthesis, and this is going to load the API key for you. And you can also print it if you are not sure it is loaded or not. You can print it to be sure. So we can print key to be sure if it's loaded or not. But once you've seen that it's loaded, you can comment this line or get rid of this line so that no one sees it. Okay, so for now, I'll comment all this code and then check if my key is loaded. So I'll clear the terminal once again, bring it up, and then run the code. And let's see if my key is loaded. All right, so you can see our API key is now loaded right here, and we are good to go. So from here, all we have to do is to test this code, okay? So I'll get rid of this line, and we can test this code. So we are importing what? Grok from grok, and we have loaded our API key. And here we can feed in our API key. So write API key is equal to our key, and that's it. So this is all you have to provide in this particular line of code. And over here you can start testing this model. So you can see here we have message, we have role as user, and over here we have content. And between these two quotes, you can put anything you want this large language model to do for you. So I can still ask it what is a bot, right here, and then I can run this code, and if everything goes well, this should return to me the answer. Okay, so I'll run this and I'm expecting an answer from this particular model. All right, so you can see we got a lot of answers. And then what I love most about this particular Grok AI platform is that you can see the speed it takes this particular model to answer it. Like, it's very fast, extremely fast. Immediately you click on it, it gives you the answer. So a bot, short for robot, is a type of computer program design. So you can see how fast it's able to answer us. Okay, so I can ask it another question. I can just do hello and I expect a short answer. I will now clear everything off and rerun it. It's going to take some time to set up this terminal before it gives me the answer. So after everything is correct, it's going to tell me, okay, hello, it's nice to meet you. And you can see the speed. So using Grok, the Grok platform gives you a lot of advantages. Apart from being free, you can see the speed at which it gives you the response. And you can use this in a real world software applications, which is very good. Okay. So guys, this is how easy you can set this up. In my upcoming tutorial, I'm going to teach you how to build a chatbot using Llama 3.1. Okay. And we'll be leveraging the API from Grok AI. Everything is going to be free. So stay updated, stay tuned, and I'll like to see you in that particular tutorial. I want you to watch that tutorial and also subscribe, share with anybody who you think will need this. Thanks for watching, and as usual, I'll see you in an upcoming tutorial.